for my blood talk. Pick him up in a space coupe, I don't let my blood walk. New freak, had to cut my other little bitch off. 50K, you could come and book a nigga for a plug walk.
I need you to hold on. Heaven is a place not too far away. We all know I should be the one to say we all make mistakes. Take my hand and hold on. Tell me everything that you need to say. 'Cause I know how it feels to be someone. Oh yeah, feels to be someone who loses the way.
Over the city, you guys. Hey, let me say this to you guys before we introduce this young man here. It's just such a pleasure to have the level of talent that we have on Spotlight Over the City. A, but this young man right here is in a whole nother lane. Like, you know how you get people who do things, you know, you got this, you got that, and the third. When I saw this young man on IG, I was just like, what? And so other people felt the same way. Hundreds of thousands of people actually felt the same way I felt. So I'm going to let Wifey introduce. But when you see the talent, make sure you follow this young man. And we're going to get his backstory when we get him on.
Yes, indeedy. Without further ado, y'all, we want to introduce you all to Elladj Baldè.
What's good, fam? Thank you for having me.
What's good?
It's a pleasure, man. You be showing off out there, bro. You make it look too easy, man. So, you're showing off out there,
showing
bro.
Showing off. Well, let's get right into it.
What inspired
you to become a figure? We're just going to go straight to it. We need to know what inspired you to become a figure skater. And just give us your backstory.
Okay, so I was born in Russia. My mom's Russian. And obviously, my dad had never skated because he's from Africa, so there's not much skating going on out there. But my mom was always very passionate about the sport. And when I was 6 years old, she introduced me to the sport. And to be very honest, I hated it. I despised it. I was cold. I was falling all the time. I went all the way into, you know, hiding my skates in the closet and telling my mom I lost my skates and I couldn't go skate. But obviously, my mom was very persistent. She always found my skates, threw them in my bag, dropped me to the rink, and and here I am now, you know, 25 years later, extremely passionate about the sport and wanting to, you know, change the culture and modernize the sport.
Oh my God,
you are definitely changing the culture. When I say changing the culture, you are, when whatever you said you set out to do, you did that and some.
What drives your passion for the music and your movement? You know, like, how do you select your songs and what moves you're gonna have?
Yeah, well, you know, growing up, you know, I was always extremely, extremely passionate about, you know, learning from Michael Jackson, learning from James Brown, learning from Usher, learning hip hop, learning breakdance. That was always the realm that I wanted to be in. And but figure skating never allowed me to do that because figure skating is so old school. It doesn't have room. You don't have room to express yourself in that way. And so for me recently, it's been extremely liberating and freeing because I've been able to just choose the music that I've always wanted to skate to, but never had the opportunity to do so. So it's really, for me, it's things that speak to me, things that make my soul on fire, and things that really, that resonate with me on a level that I can feel deep in my heart and in my soul. And that's the only thing that I skate to. If it doesn't make me feel that way, it doesn't make me feel anything, I'm not skating to it.
Oh my gosh, hey, So real quick,
I know Wifey got 100 questions, but real quick, I want to dive in and say, I see the diversity of the music that you skate to. So what inspires you? Because it's so many different genres of music that I see you bust a move to. So I'm like, how do you get it up for all these different genres of music?
Yeah, I think... As I'm developing myself as an artist, you know, I'm learning how to connect internally with what I'm listening to, right? Mm. So when I'm listening to a song, for example, Sampha, beautiful song, you know, No One Knows Me Like the Piano, you know, it's making me feel a certain way. It's making me feel a certain type of emotion. And right. when I feel an emotion, I want to go and express that. I want to go and share that and tell a story through that emotion. So, you know, the range, that's why there's so much range, because I feel like as an artist, I'm starting to connect more and more with different types of music and things that make me feel different emotions. And when I'm tapping to emotions, that's when I can go from, you know, doing, you know, Rihanna's verse on Lemon and, you know, and doing heel toe and dancing on that to then doing something like Ne Me Quitte Pas from Jacques Brel, a French song that is powerfully, that makes you want to move gracefully, you know? So when I feel something, that's when I'm, you know, I'm driven to want to use that.
Wow. So, okay. So Skate Global, you're a co-founder. What is that? Tell us about that.
So Skate Global is a company that my fiance, Michelle Dolly, and I, we founded together. And basically, we want to bring a holistic approach to figure skating. I heard you two talking about earlier about mental health, and you know, in sports and figure skating is, you know, there's a lot of damage that happens because it's a judge sport. Because you know, you're out there, you're putting yourself out there, and whether you get a mark or not depends on people judging you. So you constantly have this layer of, you know, am I good enough? And if you don't get a certain mark or you don't get a good score, you're always constantly in this space. And so, you know, helping skaters, you know, get the mental strength that they need to be able to live in that space and get out of figure skating and not be damaged is a huge part of it. And then the other one is finding fulfillment through performing and being an artist. You know, winning medals is great. You know, you can have a goal of being Olympic champion, and that's fine. But if you put your entire self-worth based on that, you're constantly going to be chasing the next thing to achieve. Whereas if you base it in fulfillment, in artistry, and how you project yourself and how you're connecting to yourself and how you're connecting to an audience, then that's something that you can experience and have with you forever. And you can find fulfillment through that. So we're trying to have almost this holistic approach and teach skaters to take a different approach to figure skating. And then you find skaters being a lot more authentic, a lot more unique, embracing the things that are unique about them. And that's when you're going to see more diversity. You're going to see more Black people skating. You're going to see more Indigenous people skating, because they'll be able to embrace the things that are authentic about them and you know, and then share that with the world.
Wow. That is, I'm just,
I love your passion.
Me
like,
too.
I see the passion that you have when you just speak about your craft. You get passionate right away about it. So I see why you're so amazing at what you do.
I love it.
You gotta,
what are you doing when you're not figure skating? That was one of the big questions that kept coming in. People want to know, like, what is your fun thing to do other than figure skating?
Well, obviously dancing is a big one for me. So I, you know, when I'm not skating, I love to take, you know, dance classes or train with some dancers. But on a more nerdy level, you know, I love playing video games and watching, you know, Marvel movies and just hanging out in that way. But on a more passionate side, though, obviously moving and dancing is something that I'm extremely passionate about. And so when I'm not skating, I'm trying to, you know, take some classes here and there.
Wow. Well, we have one more question for you before we have to wrap it up. I wish I could keep you a long time because there's so many things we want to talk to you about. But one of the things that kept coming up is what are your views on getting more diversity into figure skating? You know, like, how do you feel that is going to go? I mean, you're really breaking through.
Yeah, you're paving the way for sure.
Yeah, and I think that's where it starts. Is seeing having representation, seeing someone that looks like you being successful in a field. You know, that's when you can get inspired. And I didn't grow up with that. So that didn't allow me to tap into the things that are authentic and real about me and the things that I connect with. For the longest time, I didn't have a sense of identity. So for me, you know, you're going to see more diversity when you're going to see more representation, and you're going to see more skaters of color being out there and being themselves and being champions and being successful. I think that's a huge one. And then breaking barriers. You know, we co-founded the Figure Skating Diversity and Inclusion Alliance, and we're trying to help skaters, the next generation of skaters, with skates and blades and accessibility to rinks and scholarships, because the sport is extremely expensive. So you see a lot of people get priced out of the sport. So if we can help support them on a financial level, on an equipment level, accessibility to rinks, we'll be able to, you know, help them on their journey, you know, through figure skating and having success and whatever success means to them. So I think those are probably the main points for seeing more diversity in figure skating. And that way we will change the culture of figure skating.
I just want to say salute to you, brother.
Yes.
And when I tell you that you are definitely like, he's like the Michael Jordan of figure skating. Like,
yes.
when I saw your capabilities, and I know I haven't seen them all because I'm just stalking you on IG. But when I see you on there and I see the things you're doing and I see how diverse it is, it's totally amazing. So I just want to say I'm super proud of what you're doing. And thank you for being such
y'all have to take Mahisha off of the video.
And so thank you for being such a talent and leading the way, because you are carving a path out that's least taken.
Yes, and we want people to continue to follow you. So before we go, can you just spit out all of your information and let
everywhere,
people know
everywhere
how they can support your journey?
And anything you got coming up, let us know, because you told us something on a break that you had coming up. So let us hear about that.
Yeah. Stay tuned on Instagram tomorrow, at Elladj Baldè, TikTok as well, at Elladj Baldè. We have a video dropping tomorrow morning, and it's going to be fire. So
okay.
Follow me on my social media. And then also Figure Skating Diversity Inclusion Alliance, FSDIA. You can follow us on Instagram as well.
All right. We appreciate you so much. We consider you now part of our Spotlight family. So thank you so very much.
Yeah, and we'll put it on our page and make sure people get in touch. But you have a huge following, and it's because you're such a great talent. And keep up the great work, because a lot of people are looking at what you do and they're going forward. So you're breaking barriers, and we appreciate
whoop,
that.
Salute yes.
to
you, brother.
Thank you.
Let's give it up.
Give it up, y'all.
Great talent.
Coming up after this commercial break, we are going to chat with CEO Boss Lady Mahisha Dellinger, y'all.
Yeah, we'll be right back. Spotlight over the city. Super talent.
Yeah.